Thank you. A delightful breeze and a breathtaking view. What is it like in the future? Is the world still a beautiful place? I swear I could hear the glimmer in your eyes and the adoration in your voice. While we wait, will you not tell me about your adventures? Well, not the portentous events which led you here, but the simple delights all your own. By learning about the future world, I may gain insight into future me's plans. But more than that, I have an interest simply as a fellow traveler. Short of going somewhere oneself, there's naught more stirring than hearing another's account. Incredible! Would that I could have been there to see it! Yours is a harsh and unforgiving world. Yet in spite of this, to know that the light of mankind's potential still shines, even in that faraway place, it gives me heart. Thank you for regaling me with your tales. I will treasure every word. As you know, I was once a scholar. And among other things, I sought to understand the workings of the world. What exactly is ether? How formed the laws of nature? When sprung mankind? Riddles and mysteries beyond counting. Over the years, I have managed to find answers to some few of them. Yet rather than attain a sense of mastery, the more I understood, the more I came to hold the world and its miracles in awe. We too are miracles, each and every one of us. Born of the warm breath of life that traverses the heavens, swirling through eternity. When I fully grasped the improbability of our existence, nothing felt impossible anymore. If it could be imagined, it could be done. A passion swelled within me, an epiphany dispelling all preconceptions of what was natural and true, and a presence without, immense yet intimate. Fate, perhaps, holding us in its tender embrace. As reassuring as it was intimidating, how keenly aware I became of creation's fragility, built as it is upon precarious happenstance. I was overcome with an irrepressible urge to know the world more intimately, to hear its voice, feel its breath. I ventured forth on a journey that very day, so very long ago now. Freed from presumption and prejudice, I saw the world through a newborn's eyes. Everything fresh and new, and so, so beautiful. lands that stretched on forever. Skies one could drown in, the heartbeat of nature, silent yet strong. And amidst it all a people, beacons of light and life, laughter that warmed my heart like naught else before. They are my meaning and my purpose, my love. And so long as they need help, I cannot return to the star. Perhaps my future self is still waiting for it. The moment she can let go and walk unto the end. Safe in the knowledge that man will find his own way. You, who are our future, tell me this, and tell me true. Has your journey been good? Has it been worthwhile?
Forgive my lateness. My observation subject was rather irritable, and it took a while to settle it down.
No need to apologize. Your work takes precedence. Besides, we had a pleasant conversation in the meantime.
You're too kind. Now then, I'm told you wished to ask me some questions.
Indeed. I've an interest in one of Hermes's creations, Meteon. You witnessed a host of them take flight, yes?
Oh, that! Yes, yes, I did. 'Twas in the dark of the morn. I'd left the Thalassi after nocturnal observation. As I walked along, I spied a bright light climbing high into the southeastern skies. Then, in an instant, it was gone. Like a shooting star, only rising rather than falling. But then another shot up, then another, and another. Intrigued, I made my way to the edge to investigate. And who should I spy on an isle to the south but Hermes and Meteon, the Metea, rather. There were lots of them, and I realized they must be the shooting stars that I'd seen.
A dazzling spectacle indeed. Have you spoken with Hermes about this?
Oh, yes. The sight left such an impression on me that I approached him about his mystery project the very next day. Alas, he said that he couldn't reveal anything just yet, that he needed to conduct further tests. It shouldn't be long now, though. He often returns to that isle, and I have a feeling he's nearing a breakthrough.
Splendid. We are likewise eager for the details. Well, that is all we wish to ask. Thank you for taking the time to indulge our curiosity.
You're very welcome. It's always a pleasure to speak with other inquisitive souls. Oh, and will you be descending now? If so, I shall link the doors for you.
Please.